going to make a bit of a pipe organ coral. To do that, I'm just going to make a little circle at the top. And this piece is one that we put a lot of texture in already when we put the glue down earlier. Let me show you the trick of how to make this look like a really cool piece of coral. I'm just going to connect these. Don't even have to squeeze any more out. Just going to connect these bits here. And then again on this side. Down in here. The relief paste is so amazing. This piece in here, I love this. I don't really want to do anything to it. That piece is, that color in there is so pure. I'm going to take a bit of this just to line a bubble. You know what I'm going to do next. I hope. Here comes the brush. A little bit of water. Let's just soften that and leave some of it a little soft. A little leaf.
You will keep on this side. And I'm just going to touch. Just going to create a little shadow over here. I don't want to lose my nice line. Just going to make that. Making this a little bit darker. We'll make that coral really pop out. I'm gonna take some of my dark over here too. Bold bubbles now with relief paste. And you don't have to be a whole circle. You don't have to be complete. That one is behind her arm. Soften this up a little bit. Maybe we'll make that arm behind the circle. I think we will. The portion is wrong. So I'm going to hide that. Rub it off without me, get that comes off. I'm just going to smooth that with my finger. It's a little smooth.
Okay, don't let the name fool you on these. They say art crayon. They are like, they feel like an oil pastel, but they dry like an acrylic, and they can be water, they're water soluble as well. So let's get a little bit of this on. Now, I like to work it with my finger just a little bit. I have really messed this arm up, but it's coming out good now. I wanted to be a lot more realistic than it is. Some of this color in here. The other thing you can do is take your brush, get some water on it, and it's a little too much water. And this paints beautifully, actually. I think this is gonna be just what I'm looking for. No, I'm not. I actually do like that. I'm gonna come up and put a little bit of this right here. Not a lot. I'm gonna use my brush to work that in and blend that. It makes a nice texture. I'm gonna put a little bit back on this back arm of hers. Carry it out. And down here, I want to create this line for her back. I'm going to put a little bit of this on her face, too. Not all over, just some little bits. I'm going to put a little bit of the, just a little bit of the white beside it. Right down here. And create a really nice line there. Let's pull this straight down. This will help soften that black line that I have. I like the black line, but I want to soften this a little bit because remember, she's underwater. Just a little bit. These are lush. These are so nice. I use it like an oil pastel. I can even take a little bit and put a little highlight right here. A little white highlight right here. Remember, I'm going to come back and do some detailing on our little sea dragon. I don't want to brush this out too much. I actually like her face a lot. Maybe go by this line. I'm going to put that color, put this color on top. I have a nice pink I think I might use, so it's a little bit wild, this color, but I do really like it. Yep. Now all three of these colors, let me turn this here so you can see, all three of these colors will just blend beautifully together. Blend that right in. I'm not going to wash my brush. I'm not going to wet my brush. Soften that pink a little bit. Just a little bit down where her nose is. a little too orange. Want to blend. Just blending this. Anywhere I think I might want to lighten just a little bit. Pop a little take a tiny bit of the gesso, just a tiny bit, just a little, just a tiny bit. Add a little white in the corners of her eyes. Need to let that dry and then I'll come back in there and set that up. I'm going to jazz up her hair just a little bit. I don't want to go crazy here. Put just a little bit of this lovely, lovely color. Just a little bit on here. And I love this color too. A little bit of both of them on, and I'm going to carry this through down here. Hope you can see that. Get a little by her crown, maybe a little bit over here. Yes, needed some over there. And I'm going to make this wet, wipe it a little bit. And I'm going to start blending. More wet. I'm going to push this color because I put gold on here. I put lots of color on here. Sort of want to blend this. There's something here happening. Do you see this? I think I might see her tail. I hadn't saw her tail before, but that just might be her tail. I'm excited. Looking at my painting upside down right now, it's exciting. I just want to blend all of this. Get wood. All my color below is dry, so I can't move or hurt any of that in here. It's a lovely opportunity to really mix in some exciting colors, textures. This just might have to be a mermaid tail. Let's turn it around and see.